Hi, welcome to my Twitch stream. Haven't streamed in a while, but today I thought instead of doing a normal YouTube video, I just want to show you live how I use Blender, a free software for 3D modeling and even game creation. And yeah, and I use this software to turn simple 3D models into pixel art to use them in my game, AeroWare 2. And I just wanted to show how I do it. So if the audio levels are off, if the music is too loud or something, please let me know in the chat. And yeah, so first, this is an older version of Blender, simply because my PC is a bit older and I just think this version runs best for now. So this is 2.71, I think. Everything I show you is possible in newer versions as well. So first thing, if you never worked with Blenders, I chose the compositing view, and this is a view of your 3D model or your scene. And this is a simple car model I made, and you may be wondering why it's positioned in such a weird angle. That's because my game is a top-down view, but not 100% bird's eye, so everything is a bit tilted, so you can see the front and the top of everything. I can show you a screenshot of the game and you see what I mean. Just let me search for here. So as you can see, it's a top-down game. You see the front of the house and the top. And so for this car, I wanted to make it's similar. So I tilted the camera down. You can do it here. So I tilted it 22 degrees down, because then that was the right angle for this car. Sometimes I do 33 degrees or 36. But for this guy, I chose 22. Then in this scene, I set up a simple sun, so I have a reflection on the material of the car. That's very simple. Just tune shading with the ramp with these colors here set to constant. So I have, when I make a render, I have this simple pixelated shading. And here you can see the finished render. I chose 64 by 48 pixels and turned off everything basically that makes normally the image smoother, so no anti-aliasing, no motion blur or something like that. I turned off environment lighting, ambient occlusion, the mist, you can disable that as well. So you get a really tiny image. So it's just about this small, But you still have enough detail to so you can tell it's a car and not just some red blob. And for animation, I set up keyframes where I rotated the car in 45 degree angles. So in the game, it can turn around corners. And to save some frames, I just made basically a left turn. So I can mirror the image later in the game and use it for right turns as well. So the finished render then was lacking a bit of detail for my taste. So it's looking okay, but you see some pixels that are a bit off. So I go to Photoshop, and here you can see the true size of the image, which was very small, and I turned these two into my game engine, a game maker, and imported all the sprites and turned them into a strip. So this is a single image containing every image of the car I rendered, but then I duplicated each image. So I have three sprites for every direction. Because I wanted the tires to move, so it looks more like the car is driving and not just floating around. Very simple effect. So I painted over this strip with my colors from a color table I chose for the game. So I'm only using these colors here. Mostly, sometimes I need another one and then I add one. But to give the game a consistent look, I just use these mostly. So I painted over it. So you can see I added some outlines and I cleaned up the amount of colors, so the render had too many colors, so it looks too smooth. I don't know if you can set up the amount of colors Blender renders in newer versions. You probably can. Then I would reduce them right in Blender, but for now it uses a bit too many colors, so I reduce the amount of colors to, let's see, I think 24, something like that. Yeah, about that. So it turns similar red shades to one shade of red and so on. Then I added a grill and some indicator lights. Yeah, I made the bumper a bit more like metal and enhance the shading of the glasses and cleaned the images a bit up. And just for the tires, you can have a very simple effect for tires if you have just add a line and in the second picture is in the middle, and in the third picture the line is basically, you know, on the bottom and coming back on the top. So simple effect to make the tires spin just with three images per direction. So you can now look at it in motion. So I will add my finished car strip to the game. I will enlarge it a bit so you can see it better. So this is how it looks now in GameMaker. And as you can see, it's only the left turn because I don't need the other direction, because I simply can mirror the sprite in the game. This saves a bit of memory. And I don't need to have all the images in GameMaker itself, so I only have the first one for reference, and I load them while the game is running into the game, so I keep the file size a bit smaller. So then I can show you off the room, the scene where the car is in right now. It's my test room here. You can see all the objects and background tiles I have. There's the car. It's an object, so it can be interacted with, and I can tell them to drive along this road. You set up some paths and it will drive along the path, and when it collides with a human or another car, it will stop and honk, and when that person or other car is not in the way anymore, then it will continue its path. I set this one up to run in circles just for testing it. And here you can see other things I made in Blender. So these trees, for example, I made in Blender. These fern or small baby pine trees or whatever I made in Blender too. And every human you see is also was a 3D model. So I can show you how I did trees and humans. So let me open another project here. For example, this pine tree. And this one is moving when it's windy. So you can see it's moving a little bit. And I basically just moved around these circles. And these are made from an SVG file. Let's see if I can find it, and then right, so I imported the SVG file. That's a vector image. I made that vector image in Inkscape. I can show you all that in a minute. I think this is it. right. So here it is. So it starts out just like a flat shape, and I set the origin to center like that. So this is basically just a filled curve, and then you turn that into 3D and extrude it a little bit, and then I basically put multiple of these rings together to form a tree, and then I can animate every ring independently. I show you another tree. Maybe this one. This one moves a bit with its tree trunk as well. And the trunk is moving on bones. It's just two bones. You can also use a curve or move them by hand as you please. And this will look a little bit like that. For the finished tree, I changed the lighting a little bit, so because it's too much of too bright on this side here. But you get the idea. A very simple way of making trees, because I think, especially animating trees and drawing them all by hand, is very time-consuming. So I tried this method and it works pretty well. And if you have any questions, you can always ask me on Twitter or on Twitch or YouTube or whatever you like. So now I will show you humans. I think this one is the right one. All right, so this is the player character. So as you can see, I'm not good at all at 3D modeling, but so this thing mostly consists of spheres and cones. It's very simple, but for my game it's enough. As you can, it's very simple, a bit chibi style, like Japanese RPGs. And I used this drawing I made before as a reference. And you can also see I got another set of legs here with bended knees I used in some frames. And I gave him a bicycle as well. And here you can see the frames that I use for walking and for riding the bicycle. And for sitting on a bench. And here I removed the eyes for some reason, probably because I want to redraw them or something. Here is for climbing a ladder. And I also made another project where he is swimming. Let's see, here's the character swimming. And for that, I made a pool of water around him that with some waves. That's also just some circles that are getting smaller and bigger. So very simple stuff. It's a bit transparent, so you can see it's his body underwater. That's how I do human characters. And the last use for Blender is battle backgrounds. Let me show you some screenshots from the game real quick, because it's based on Pokemon the game. You got not only you got the overworld but also battle sequences, and for that I made backgrounds. So let me see if I have some screenshots. These are all overworld screenshots. Like this one, for example. Of course, these are all work in progress, but I wanted to make a beach at night, and this background is made in Blender as well, without the sky. The sky I made by hand, and the characters as well. But I can show you one of these background scenes. For example, a forest. So it may look messy, but I don't care. If the end frame looks good, then it's all right. So I've got a couple of lights, really, really crude trees, and some grass and hills. It's just some cylinder flowers here, but in the end this doesn't look too bad. So if I drew this by hand, probably took way longer. I some slight miss in this one, and you can easily change the lighting conditions to make it a night scene and or sunrise or whatever, or change some trees around without having to draw everything again. So that's why I use Blender for battle backgrounds as well. All right, so I think that's for now all I wanted to show you. So if you have any questions, leave a comment or tweet at me, and I will happily answer your questions. Maybe I will do a stream about the music of the game you hear in the background, and or programming if you ever want to know how I do that. So yeah, thanks for watching for now, and see you soon.